गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, माई सेल्फ अनुभूति सक्सेना, योर SST टीचर. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू लेसन 9. द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज मेजर लैंडफॉर्म्स एंड वाटर बॉडीज. डू यू नो वॉट आर लैंडफॉर्म्स? Landforms are the natural features and shapes existing on the surface of the earth. They have different physical characteristics and are spread out all over the planet Earth. We know we live on the planet Earth and there are so many different types of physical characteristics and features which we have to read. You all must have noticed that the earth is not the same everywhere. The land part of the earth is high at some places and too low at other. Some areas are lush green while others are dry and barren. We see on the earth places different. Oceans and continents constitute to form very large landforms. What do you mean by the landforms? When we see the oceans and continents, different types of plateaus, plains are there. These are the forms of the landforms. So we will study about the landforms here. Whereas the mountain, vast plains and plateaus comes under the category of large landforms. Individual mountains, hills, valleys, river banks and hillside slopes form to be intermediate and small landforms. Let us learn about the major landforms in details. First, mountains. All of you have seen the mountains. Mountains are the natural elevation on the earth's surface. They are the highest landforms, usually found with broad base and conical top with steep sides. They occupy almost 1/4 of the total land area of the earth. The pointed tip of the mountain is called a peak. A series of mountains is called a mountain range. The Himalayas. All of you have listened the name of this Himalayas. The Himalayas are the longest mountain range. The temperature on the mountains remains less as compared to the plains. The Mount Everest is the highest mountain peak in the world. Now, plateaus. Plateaus are elevated highland with a more or less flat surface on its top. It has a large area on its top and a steep or gentle slope on its sides. They are surrounded by lower land or mountain ranges. Due to the flat top, these landforms are also known as tablelands or highlands. The height of the plateaus varies from a few hundred meters to 1,000 meters. The Deccan Plateau in India, Western Plateau in Australia, Mongolian Plateau, etc. are some important plateaus of the world. Plains. Plains are the vast stretches of flat land. They have little change in elevation and are usually lower than the land surrounding them. Plains near the ocean are called coastal plains. Most of the big cities are located in plains as it is easier to build houses, buildings, roads and other structures in the plains. Hence, they are heavily polluted. We all are living on the plains. Where we are building the houses, roads, hospitals, everything we are making here. So these are very polluted. The northern plains of India, Nile Valley plains of Africa, Yangtze plains of China, etc. are some significant plains of the world. Next is deserts. Deserts are large, dry and barren area of lands which receives little or no rainfall throughout the year. The weather conditions in desert is extreme. It is very hot in day and very cold at night. There are two types of deserts, hot deserts and cold deserts. Hot deserts are covered with sand. Animals like camels, snakes, lizards and rats can be found there. Thar desert in India is a hot desert. This is the example of hot desert. Now, cold deserts are covered with snow. They receive snowfall during winter. Animals like penguin, whales and fur seals can be found in these deserts. The Antarctica is the world's biggest cold desert. Next is island. An island is a piece of land that is surrounded by water on all sides. The Andaman and Nicobar and Lakshadweep are the Indian islands situated in the Bay of Bengal and the Arabian Sea respectively. Now the continents, we will read about the continents. The continents can be defined as huge land masses rising above the sea level. These continents are separated from one another by huge water bodies. There are seven continents on the earth, namely Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Antarctica, Europe and Australia. I repeat the name: Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Antarctica, Europe and Australia. Now we will read about these. Asia. Asia is the largest and the most populated continent on the earth. It is home to half of the world's population. It comprises 48 countries. Mount Everest, the highest peak of the world, is located in Asia and the height is 8,848 meter. The combined land masses of Europe and Asia is called Eurasia. Second, Africa. Africa is the second largest continent on the earth. It is also second largest in terms of population. This continent comprises 54 countries and is home to about 15% of the world population. It was also called as the Dark Continent. Why? Because very little was known to the outside world until the last century. The world's longest river, the Nile, lies in this continent. Third is North America. North America is the third largest continent of the world. It lies in the northern hemisphere and the western hemisphere. It is the fourth largest continent in population. 7.5% of the population lives in this continent. It is surrounded by the Pacific Ocean in the west and the Atlantic Ocean in the east, the Arctic Ocean in the north and the Gulf of Mexico in the south. North America is connected to South America by a narrow stretch of land called the Isthmus of Panama. Next is South America. South America is the fourth largest continent and roughly triangular in shape. This continent is fifth in terms of population. South America is home to the world's largest river, the Amazon. It is generally considered as the subcontinent of Americas. The Andes mountain range, which runs through its land from north to south, is the longest mountain range in the world. Fifth, Antarctica. Antarctica is the fifth largest continent in terms of area after Asia, Africa, North America, and South America. It is almost twice the size of Australia. It is the southernmost continent of the Earth. It is surrounded by the Southern Ocean. It is the only uninhabited continent in the world. There is no permanent human settlement here. Antarctica is also known as the frozen or white continent. Antarctica is the coldest, driest, and windiest continent. Here, the temperature has reached -89°C. Sixth is Europe. Europe is the second smallest continent in the world. It covers nearly 2% of the Earth's surface. It lies totally in the northern hemisphere. It is the third most populous continent after Asia and Africa. Most populated continent is Asia, second Africa, and third is Europe. Europe comprises 50 countries and takes up 6.8% of the world's total land area. It is separated from Asia by the Caspian Sea, Caucasus Mountains, and the Black Sea. 7. Australia. Australia is the smallest continent in the world. It is the only continent that is also as a country. Australia is surrounded by water from all sides. That is why it is also called an island continent. It is surrounded by the Indian Ocean in the west, the Southern Ocean in the south, the Pacific Ocean in the east, and the Arafura Sea and the Timor Sea in the north. It is one of the least populated continents of the world. It lies entirely in the southern hemisphere. Now we will discuss about oceans. Oceans, we studied about the land masses which cover only 30% of the Earth's surface. The larger population is covered by water. The larger portion is covered by water. 70% of the Earth's surface is covered by water. The large bodies of water that surrounds the continents are called oceans. I repeat, the large bodies of water that surrounds the continents are called oceans. Oceans are large expanses of sea. Oceans form a huge part of the hydrosphere. The ocean water is not static. It keeps moving all the time. although all the oceans are interconnected, they are generally divided into 5 oceans. The 5 major oceans in the decreasing order of their sizes also are: first is the Pacific Ocean, second the Atlantic Ocean, third the Indian Ocean, fourth the Arctic Ocean, fifth the Antarctic Ocean or the Southern Ocean. The Pacific Ocean. The Pacific Ocean is the largest and deepest ocean in the world. It covers about 1/3 of the earth. The Mariana Trench, 11,034 meter, the world's deepest trench, is situated in the Pacific Ocean. The Pacific Ocean is almost triangular in shape. Its average depth is 4,572 meter. It is surrounded by Asia and Australia in the west and North America and South America in the east. Almost 3/4 of the world's active volcanoes are found in the Pacific Ocean. Now, second is the Atlantic Ocean. The Atlantic Ocean is the second largest ocean in the world. It is an S-shaped ocean and is surrounded by North America and South America in the west, and Europe and Africa in the east. It has a very long and intended coastline that provides good sites for sheltered harbors and seaports. It provides the busiest trade and commerce route to the world. Its average depth is 3,376 meters. The coastline of the Atlantic Ocean is longer than that of the coastlines of the Pacific Oceans and the Indian Oceans put together. Now, third is the Indian Ocean. The Indian Ocean is the third largest ocean in the world. It is the only ocean in the world which is named after a country, that is India. It is surrounded by Africa in the west and by Australia in the east. In the north, it is entirely bounded by Asia. Therefore, it is also called as half an ocean. Its southern part is linked with the Pacific Ocean and the Atlantic Ocean. Its average depth is 4,000 meter. Next, fourth one is the Arctic Ocean. The Arctic Ocean is the smallest and shallowest of all the oceans in the world. It lies around the North Pole. Its average depth is 1,260 meter. It is almost entirely bounded by land masses. Throughout the year, its water remains almost frozen. It is bounded by the northern parts of North America, Europe, and Asia. The narrow Bering Strait connects it to the Pacific Ocean. Next, fifth is the Antarctic Ocean or Southern Ocean. The southern parts of the three oceans, that is the Indian Ocean, the Atlantic Ocean and the Pacific Ocean, surrounding the continent of Antarctica are referred to as the Southern Ocean. It is situated within the Antarctic Circle and surrounds the South Pole. This ocean is considered to be the youngest of all oceans geologically. Now, different types of water bodies. Water on the earth is present in different types of water bodies. These are differentiated on the basis of size, shapes, type of water, etc. The largest water bodies are oceans, which we studied in this chapter. Let us learn some other type of water bodies. First is rivers. All of you have seen the rivers, Ganga River, Yamuna River. So we are talking about the rivers. A river is a large flowing water body which typically ends in an ocean or sea. It is a fresh water body that usually originate in mountains or an elevated area. The world's longest river is the Nile in Egypt, followed by the Amazon River in South America. Lakes. Lakes are the huge and deep water filled depressions on the earth's surface. These are fed by the surface water or the groundwater. Lakes can be fresh water or salt water. They are completely surrounded by land. Major lakes of the world are Caspian, Baikal, Superior, Dal, Sambar, Chilika, etc. Seas. Seas are large water bodies but is smaller than oceans. They are partly enclosed by a landmass and are connected to an ocean. The largest sea is the South China Sea, which holds 100 of islands in its waters. The Caribbean Sea, Mediterranean Sea and the Bering Sea are some of the world's largest seas. They are extensively used as transport lanes for ships. Fourth is glacier. Glaciers are frozen rivers which move very slowly. They store around 75% of the earth's fresh water. If these get melted, the sea levels would rise up to 230 feet. There are ancient water bodies which are even 40 million years old. So, now we are concluding our chapter. All the exercises and question answers of this chapter we will discuss in our next video. So, home assignment is you have to read the chapter carefully and try to learn all the names of all the continents, oceans, and you have to learn everything very carefully. Thank you, everyone.